Good morning, students. Good morning, especially to the coming ninth batch. We are now going under a very critical situation, so we are staying in home for this coronavirus and starting the online classes and studies in the home. So today I also start my math class for you all. For mathematics, first chapter for you all is the chapter is real number. So what is the chapter? The chapter is called as real number. As the name is suggesting real number, this is a number system. This is the big number system in our mathematics, which is containing all the number systems with it. So when we are going to start a real number system, we can start with a big number system, biggest number system, that is called complex number. So we are going to start from the complex number. Understood? We are going to start from a complex number. What I said? Complex number. Now you see, I wrote here, my chapter number 1 heading is real number, and what I did, I wrote here complex number. So try to understand this complex number. The word complex means it is having a variety types of numbers in it. So which is, we can broadly divide the complex number system into two parts. One is called as, into two parts we can divide it. One is called as real number, another called as imaginary number. The numbers which we can imagine. So that is imaginary numbers. Don't worry, I am coming to explain you about these two divisions of complex numbers. So our mathematics deals with the biggest number, that is called complex number. In complex number, all the numbers are available. So when I said about a complex number, this complex number is divided into two types. One is called as your real number. Today we are going to discuss about it. The real number today is our discussion point. And the imaginary numbers, later we are going to discuss about it. In higher studies you are going to read. But I will explain what is this imaginary numbers said as. So when I come to real number, this particular number system again consists of many number systems. As you know, in earlier classes we are already gone through the many number systems. First number system is called as the natural number. Natural number means the number which comes spontaneously, naturally. For example, I am giving you an example. One mother has two kids. So he is going to share, she is going to give some chocolates. So what she will do? She is giving 4 chocolates to the elder and 2 chocolates to the younger. Then suddenly you will observe that the younger one is starting to cry. Why? Because she is knowing that my elder one is getting some more chocolates from me. So this is a natural observation from the two kids. So when I am going to say about the natural number, this natural number is coming spontaneously. So it is coming spontaneously. So it is already from 1 to 9. We are already taken. So, and we are giving it as under the set of natural number. The natural number, the symbol is N. I will write it, but I am trying to explain you. Then everybody knows about it. Then come to the whole number system. What is a whole number? Whole number system, after the discovery of 0, 0 is called as a special number. After 1 to 9, after 9, what should be there? Nobody knows. So there is no number. Number stopped there. So a genius Indian mathematician like Aryabhatta, he discovered the special number called 0. After getting the 0, they started to go for the 2 digits, 3 digits, 4 digits, like this many digits of numbers. So from 0 to infinity system of number is called as whole number system, and denoted by W. So let's start to write it. Real numbers, we are starting the I am going for the first one is, I said you, the first one is called as the natural number. First one is called as the natural number. So what is a natural number? Natural numbers. The natural numbers, it is from, this is the set symbol, it is from 1 to 9. Many books are saying 1 to infinity. Many books are saying 1 to infinity, but 1 to infinity was not there because after 9 nobody knows what is the number. After the discovery of 0, it is going under the format of whole number, and the 0 discovered there. So this is called as the whole number. Whole numbers are from the discovery of 0, then 0 to infinity. It is the 0 right hand side, 0 to infinity. So the symbol for this is called as W. We are taking as W and this is as N. So this is the called as the natural number. This is called as the whole number. Whole number after the discovery of 0 to infinity. Understood? Now I am coming to the point that many after the discovery of natural number, it is from 0. It is 0 RHS, right hand side. Then after the 0 right hand side, what should be in the left hand side? Then they start to think about it. They got the integers. That is called integers and denoted by Z, and these integers are from negative 0 and up to 0 right hand side infinity. So when I am saying the set of integers, it is the from the 0 left hand side, that is 0 left hand side, this is a negative up to infinity, and 0 positive side, that is up to infinity. So this whole number, this total, is coming under the set of integers, which is denoted by the letter Z. So these three are the basic number systems in our mathematics. First is the natural number, it is from 1 to 9 and called as N, and whole number, it is from 0 right hand side, which is called as W, and it's a set of integers which is symbolized by Z. It is 0 left hand side to up to infinity, that means negative numbers including 0, and 0 positive side. So now a very very important number system we are going to discuss about today, that is called as the rational number system. What is that called as? The fourth one is called as the rational number system. What is rational number? The rational number, they give the symbol for it as Q, and they said, suppose I am drawing here, you see, I am just going to draw 0, 1, and in between 0 to 1, how many numbers are there? Definitely there are billions and billion numbers. But if I will add 0 plus 1 and by 2, then what is coming? 1 by 2. Then where is this 1 by 2 in this number system? So what is 1 by 2 called as? So 1 by 2, the name 1 by 2, it is called as a fraction. The 1 by 2 is called as a fractional number. So a rational number system deals with the fractions. The rational number deals with the fractions. So the fractions are, the definition for the rational number is a number which can be expressed in the form of P by Q. A number which can be expressed in the form of P by Q. That means this number, rational number, can be expressed in the form of P by Q. That means numerator by denominator, P by Q, where P and Q will belong to Z. Z means integers. The P and Q, numerator and denominator, both will belong to the set of integers. So, and the Q, the most important point is that the Q must not be equal to 0. The Q should not be equal to 0. The denominator must not be equal to 0. That means we cannot write 1 by 0 as a rational number. We cannot write. But we can write 0 by 1 is a rational number because denominator is 1 here. But here the denominator is 0. If the denominator is 0, it is valueless. It is undefined. But when the value is 1 here, it can be defined, that is 0. The value is governing, that is equal to 0. So now we discussed about the four number systems here. One is called natural number, which is spontaneously coming, naturally coming, that is from 1 to 9, the natural number, and the whole number, that is 0 to infinity, called as the set of whole numbers, that is W, and the integers are the symbolized by Z, and it is 0 negative side and 0 positive side. 0 negative side up to infinity and 0 positive side up to infinity are denoted by Z. Then today we are going for a very important number system, that is called rational number. Rational number, the definition of rational number is a number which can be expressed in the form of P by Q, that means fractional form. It's in the numerator by denominator form. If you are expressing in the P by Q form, and where the denominator must not be equal to 0. The dq must not be equal to 0. I took a fraction here p by q, where q is not equal to 0. If the denominator will be equal to 0, I showed it here, 1 by 0, the denominator 0, so it is cannot be called as a rational number. This cannot be called as a rational number. Why? Because it is undefined. So the symbol for the rational number is q. Now, after this, I hope you all understood it. I will ask the questions. After my explanations, you have to answer, and on which name I am calling those persons, definitely they are going to answer my questions. And now I am going to say you about a very important number system, that is called as the number 5 system is called as the irrational numbers. So irrational numbers, the name suggesting irrational, that means they are not rational. The number is word is saying irrational, that is they are not rational means they cannot be expressed in the form of P by Q. So, if they cannot be expressed in the form of P by Q, but they can be a fraction. Suppose I am taking a number example. By example, I am giving to you here, you see, I am taking an example of 1 by 3. You see, 1 by 3 can be expressed in the form of P by Q. P is 1 here, Q is 3 here. We are going to divide 1 with 3. 1 with 3. So, can we divide? 3 threes are 9. Again 1 came. Again for decimal, I am taking a 0. 3 threes are 9. Again 1 came. So, this 3 is going to continue here. So, due to this continuation, we cannot express this irrational numbers as fractions. So, which number cannot be explained as rational form, cannot be expressed in rational form, in P by Q form, definitely those numbers are called as the irrational numbers. Irrational numbers, again I am going to discuss it in my next video. Irrational number will be one chapter, one session for you, because there is a lot of things in irrational number. So I will take it in next session. Thank you very much.